Hi, I'm Jim Langridge. I work in applied technologies here at Waters. New technologies are developed to solve a problem. At Waters, we start with the challenges facing scientists in their labs and deliver benefit through capability. The main challenges facing biological research is the ability to confidently identify and characterize components in complex mixtures, either proteins, metabolites, or lipids. This requires both high sensitivity and selectivity across a wide dynamic range. Sample throughput has also become critical. Analyzing large numbers of samples allows subtle but robust quantitative changes to be confidently determined. So throughput and productivity are important. DIA approaches have been around for a number of years now and have proved to be important techniques, particularly for label-free quantitative studies. However, existing techniques have limited selectivity to confidently identify molecules, and the speed and duty cycle of the techniques has often been compromised to achieve this in existing strategies. This is why we developed SONAR.
Hi, my name is John Chipperfield and I work in the Research, Development and Evaluation Department here at Waters Wilmslow.
SONAR is our new data-independent acquisition mode that we're releasing for our Xevo QTOF platform, and it's perfect for those very complex sample mixtures. Essentially, it uses a fast-resolving quadrupole scan to mass-filter the ion beam prior to any fragmentation and detection in the TOF. Using this technique, we're able to generate up to 2,000 individual and very clean MSMS spectra per second for the duration of the chromatographic run. In essence, we get a very complete survey of the sample. After peak detection in the time of flight spectrum and quadrupole scan dimensions, we're able to say very precisely which fragments are coming from which precursor ions.
We find this approach universally gives us not only a greater number of identifications in library-based searches, but crucially a greater confidence in the identifications we get.
So firstly, it fits really well on a chromatographic time frame, but also it's still quantitative. So you don't need to do repeat injections. If you've got any targets of interest, you can pull out that information directly from the SONAR data. It's very robust and it's simple to use. It drops right into any Progenesis workflow you might be using or a Symphony pipeline. It's also compatible with a bunch of different third-party open source informatics platforms.